are now in the paint. This is the final episode of the Pac-12 regular season, and we just want to take a moment to thank you for coming on this journey with us and following these 12 women's basketball teams through the course of the Pac-12 season. And thus far, we've been kind of like your tour guides. I'm Roz Goldunwede, he's Kevin Dana.
Hey, hey.
And KD, one final time, what do you have for the good people today?
It's going to start out as it usually does, Roz. We're going to have an updated look at the conference standings, tell you what's been going around in Pac-12 play. And then we're going to do something a little different this time. Team Dazzle versus Team Kevo. We'll tell you more about that as it comes time. But let's get to the standings, Roz.
All right. What you're seeing right now, it's getting really close to the finalization of these standings as we head into Pac-12 tournament time. And again, I'm going to urge you to look at those top four teams in the standings, because those will be the ones that do get that first round bye. And I think anyone in that 3, 4, 5, 6 spot, USC, Oregon State, Arizona State, UCLA, there can be some shuffling there, and you might see it happen this week. So people are really fighting for that extra rest. But before that, I do want to take a moment to just give a quick shout out to Oregon State. I mean, this is a program last season that was 2-16 in conference play. They finished dead last, 10th in conference, and now this year are in contention for a first round bye in the tournament. Kudos to the Beavers for being able to rebuild, win, and get it done. Now that's a turnaround.
Scott Ruick has to be one of the front runners for Pac-12 Coach of the Year because of the way he's been able to really get things going in a positive direction for Oregon State. He has a shooter, Allie Gibson, has a do-it-all player in Earlisa Marchbanks, and then his shot blocker, Patricia Bright, leading the conference in blocks.
Watch out for Oregon State.
Roz, it's time for that special segment, Team Dazzle versus Team Kevo, to wrap things up here.
All right, what's going on? Explain it to us.
All right, so we're going to be your GMs. Okay. We're going to be picking teams like it's a pickup game on the playground. And we're going to have a starting five and then one bench player. Now, here's the thing. You can only pick one player from each team, so all 12 teams are going to be represented. And since I am such a gentleman, Roz, I'm going to let the lady go first.
NECA Agbumike.
I figured that.
You got to go with her. Yeah. I mean, she's a favorite for Pac-12 Player of the Year and in contention for National Player of the Year. She's leading the conference in points and rebounds, about 22 points per game, about 10 rebounds. And she's going to be the anchor for my team. Pretty much every single thing on offense is going to go through NECA Agbumike. Her hands will touch the ball every offensive set. She's one of these players that can just about do it all. She's physical strong. She can get in there and rebound and body with the bigs, post back to the basket, but she also is very versatile. She does have that nice footwork. She can take you off the dribble. She will hit the mid-range jump shot. She's one of these players that I think will also be a leader for my team, and I'm comfortable giving her the team.
All right, well, you're going to have your senior leader. I'll take mine. What's going to be a veteran-laden group for me, Amanda Johnson out of Oregon. She was averaging 20 points and 10 rebounds before going down with a thumb injury, but she has been pretty much consistent at around 19 points, 10 rebounds since she has come back. Her second game back, she hasn't been slowed down by that thumb injury, by the way. 26 points and 12 rebounds in that second game back for Amanda Johnson. And she could stretch out that defense as well. She knows how to shoot the perimeter jumper and knock down the three, so I'm very comfortable with Amanda Johnson hanging in there down low.
I like Amanda Johnson. I think that's a great pick.
That's why I picked her.
All right, but I just don't see how she's going to deal with both NECA Agbumike and my second pick, Cal's Jennifer Brandon.
Okay.
All right, when you see those two picks, you know a philosophy of my team is going to be rebounding the basketball. NECA Agbumike, number one in the conference in rebounding. Jennifer Brandon, number three in the conference in rebounding, giving you about 10 rebounds per game. But not only are we going to dominate you on the glass, KD, we're also going to be really efficient and kill you inside the paint on offense. And we're going to get that high-low action going on. I'm going to put NECA in deep, and I'm going to put Jennifer Brandon out around the free throw line and make you pick your poison. Want to sag in and help on NECA Agbumike? Cool, because Jennifer Brandon, free throw line extended, can knock that shot down. Or she's going to pump it inside. High-low, we are going to beat you that way. What?
Oh, sticking to your Tara roots over there, huh?
Yes, we like to go high-low, and we go big or go home. Shout out to Tara Vandermeer.
All right, well, you didn't think I was just going to let Amanda Johnson hang in there down by her lonesome in the paint, did you?
Well, I wasn't sure what your, you know, strategic mind was like,
KD. I've been thinking, and that's why I'm going to combat your Jennifer Brandon with her older sister, Kimberly Brandon of Arizona State.
Sister card. You're going to play that one.
Yes, I am going to play that one because she knows how to defend her sister. 10 points, 7 rebounds per game as well. And if I do decide to go small, she can step out on the perimeter as well because she is a player that has been at the 2, the 3, and now the 4 where she is most comfortable at now in her senior year at Arizona State. So I have some options there, and she could rebound. Amanda Johnson can rebound. You talk about your team being able to get boards. Well, so can mine.
Well, my team can also run, and I'm going to start now with my point guard pick. It's going to be USC's Ashley Corral, and I trust her with the rock.
Good choice.
Pretty much over the course of her career at USC, she's shown that she can not only pass the ball, make other players better, averaging over 3 assists per game, but she does it efficiently. She doesn't turn it over much, and she can shoot that three-pointer, and she will shoot that three-pointer, so you got to come out and guard her, but she can blow by you and beat you to the rim, and she's going to draw defenders, but she's really good at keeping her dribble alive and head up, so when she's drawing all this commotion in the paint, she's going to hit cutters with the no-look or the behind-the-back. And I like a little mustard on my hot dog, I'm not going to lie, and that's why I'm giving Ashley Corral the keys to my offense.
My team's going to run too, but for those possessions when it's in the half court and I just need someone who can get a bucket in a big possession, I'm turning to Markel Walker. We're going to keep it in Los Angeles for the Bruin. Markel, 14 points, the best penetrator in the conference, one of the craftiest finishers in the conference. Okay. She knows how to get past a defender. You want to talk about blowing by someone and being able to finish tough? That's the definition of Markel Walker if you looked it up in the dictionary. So that's going to be my number 3 selection. Markel Walker going to be able to get it done in the half court sets for me.
Okay, I see Markel Walker. That's a good pick.
Oh, that's a great pick.
But I see your Markel Walker, and I'm going to raise you Davelin White. I mean, you want to talk about buckets and scoring. How do you miss Arizona's Davelin White? She's the number 2 scorer in the conference, giving you about 17 points per game, but she also rebounds the ball, almost 7 rebounds per game. She also can pass the ball, so she's going to make other players better, and she can shoot the 3. I mean, she is my do-it-all player. With Davelin White in the lineup, I can go big. I can also go small. Either way, she's my versatile do-everything player. And then also, the biggest reason why she's in my lineup is for defense, and that's going to be another strategy for my team. She's number 2 in the conference for steals, so I'm going to stick her on whoever you got as a point guard and have her frustrate the point guard, being active on the ball, getting deflections, getting steals, or I'll put her in a passing lane where she can use her smarts and caginess to pick off a pass and then push the ball in transition for buckets.
That's a nice pick, Roz, but
this is what I do. I pick good players because I'm a great GM. Thank you.
The second best GM on this show. Davelin leads her team in scoring. Mm-hmm. 7 rebounds per game.
This is true. Why I picked her.
So I'm going to do the same thing with someone who leads her team in scoring, gets 7 rebounds per game. Also on the perimeter, Chucky Jeffrey of Colorado.
Okay.
And I do believe it was a few weeks back where you diagrammed how Chucky Jeffrey beat Davelin White's Arizona team.
Yep, she did hit a game winner.
She's a very clutch player.
Yes, she is clutch, but in order for her to be clutch, that means you'd have to be in a close game with my team, and I plan on blowing you out of the water.
The only reason this would be close, Roz, is if I take the foot off the gas.
Yeah, whatever, Katie.
So, but that's why Chucky Jeffrey is in there, to make sure it doesn't come to that, because she is such a clutch performer and can get buckets in tough situations as well, just like Markel Walker. 7 rebounds, a very good rebounding guard, and could also pass as well, more than 3 assists per game for Chucky Jeffrey. And she leads her team in that category as well. So that's my number 4 selection. Who's going to round out your starting 5?
My starting 5 is going to end, actually, with a freshman.
Okay, young.
I'm going to go young, and I'm going to bring on Oregon State's Allie Gibson. And the reason I'm going young, I like her kind of freshman bravado. She's fearless. She's a scorer. She has a scorer's mentality. But the number 1 reason why she's in my starting lineup is because she can shoot the 3, and she will stretch the defense. Every single one of my guards I've mentioned are in the top 5 in the conference for 3-pointers made. But Allie Gibson is also in the top 5 for 3-point field goal percentage. And pretty much I told you who I got inside. I got Nneka Ogumike. I got Jennifer Brandon. So we need to stretch the defense to make sure teams aren't double teaming in there or sagging in the paint. And now I'm going to force the defense to make those decisions. What are you going to do? Double Nneka, or are you going to come out and guard Allie Gibson? Either way, we're going to beat you inside and out.
Oh, you seem very sure of your team, Roz. That's okay, because I'm going to hit you with my ball handler, someone who's going to handle that pressure that Davlin White's going to bring. And it's Utah's Janita Badon, one of the best decision makers in the conference. Not only the 10 points and 6 rebounds, she leads the conference in assists at 5.7 per. And not only that, 1.66 to 1 assist to turnover ratio, something you need out of your point guard. She makes good decisions. She's not going to turn the ball over that often, and she's going to give us good shots in our offensive sets. So that's my number 5. I'm surprised you didn't swoop her up.
That's a good pick.
Yep.
That's a good pick. But I've got someone coming off the bench. It's my final pick, and I'm really surprised you missed her.
I didn't miss anybody. I don't know what you're talking about.
Washington, my girl, Regina Rogers.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Don't
Sorry.
Be too hard on
Sorry.
Yourself.
Yeah.
But
not.
She's coming off the bench, but on any given day for my squad, she could be a starter. Regina Rogers, she's the number 3 scorer in the conference. She's number 1 shooting from the field, so she's very efficient, nearly 60%, and we are going to go inside to her when she's on the court. In fact, I'm going to go big. My team can go huge. I think Nneka Ogumike is talented enough, especially at the collegiate level, to swing her out to the 3, put Jennifer Brandon out at the 4, and then you put Regina Rogers in at the 5, and pretty much we say, we are going to pound it inside. Who's got the mismatch? Okay, cool. Go. Your turn. What are you going to do about that size, KD?
You know what? I'm not going to match you with size on that last pick. Nice pick, Roz. I'll give you that. But I got Jasmine Perkins for you. 2.7 steals per game, leading the conference. She's really going to get into your guards on the defensive end. And I'm very confident putting her out there to be able to harass your perimeters. And I think that's going to cause some turnovers for your team. And I'm going to make things a little tough for Razzle Dazzle.
All right. Well, it looks like it's going to be a good game on the court. And KD, bring it.
Oh, I will. Don't worry about that, Roz. Who do you think is going to win this matchup of Team Dazzle versus Team Kevo? Hit us up on Twitter and let us know, at Rosgo21, at Kevo408. It's okay if you send a few charity votes her way. I'm very confident in my team. But Roz, it's been a pleasure doing this show with you.
Same here.
Nick behind the camera doing a great job for us as always.
Thanks, Nick.
Thank you very much for watching In the Paint Episode 8 and all the episodes we've had before that. Thank you very much for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.